In 2014, Harlan Inglis filed a wrongful death lawsuit against the Royal St. Lucia Police Force, and on July 24, 2015, an inquest into the death of Shakadan Daniel declared that the 22-year-old was indeed killed unlawfully. A post-mortem examination found that Chakadan Daniel had died of asphyxia. For years, the father of the deceased fought for justice for his son, even when it seemed like he was fighting a losing battle.
Right now, I'm trying to get justice for my son. I'm not getting any justice. I cannot say anything about my lawyer, which is Mr. Green, but there is a foul play in my son's death that the secret not coming out. They told me about they're trying to get the policeman who killed Chakadan. When, to me, they know who killed Chakadan.
Unfortunately, Harlan Inglis died before receiving any form of justice for his son. Inglis collapsed along Jeremy Street on Saturday and was taken to the Victoria Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. The circumstances surrounding his death are still unclear. One thing is certain, he will never see the alleged perpetrators brought to justice.
It's time that the Lord do something about my son's death, because they have been me walking up and down, up and down, up and down. They found the policeman guilty for killing my son, and I need some justice for my son right now.
On Wednesday, December 6, 2018, some six officers who were on duty at the Micoud Police Station at the time of Daniel's incarceration were brought in for questioning on orders of the now Director of Public Prosecution, Dazrin Green, who was legal counsel to the family at the time. No charges have been laid against the officers, and they remain on active duty. For the DBS News World, I am Sharefil Gaillard.